As we walked the path along the ridge of the downs to Shanktonbury, my grandmother told me of its creation. A few miles east of the ring lies Devil's Dyke, a deep, dry coombe cut into the landscape by a river spawned from the dissolution of Ice Age permafrost. The river is gone, the valley remains. That's one story. Winnie told me another. The devil, she said, wished to destroy Sussex and wandered the county in search of occasion. There he encountered St. Dunstan, a wise and wily Sussex man. Being a cocky fellow, Beelzebub gave Dunstan the choice of how his homeland would be destroyed. Dunstan proposed that the county be flooded. But how to do it? After all, the downs protect Sussex, cradle it against encroachment of the sea. And to cut through the hills, that would take ages upon ages, even for the likes of the devil. The bait was taken, and the bet was made. The downs would be cut through before the cock crowed daybreak, or the devil would leave Sussex alone. Satan dug and cut through the night, well on his way to completing the task, when something happened. My grandmother told me that an old woman was awakened by the ruckus and, investigating with a lantern, climbed over the downs, her light appearing as the dawn and sending an infuriated devil running. Belloc tells the tale too, and in his version, it's the power of prayer, St. Dunstan rising every rooster in the west to crow at once. The Devil's Dyke remains, as do the mounds of chalky earth he furiously shoveled to and fro, landing across the county, piles at Mount Caburn and Rackham Mount, Ditchling Beacon and Cissbury Ring, and, of course, Shanktonbury. The devil lives on. Winnie told me how running around the ring seven times, Widdershins would summon him, complete with an ambiguous bowl of soup. That story changes too, the summoned becoming a legion of Roman soldiers or a horde of Saxon berserkers. Perhaps merely a twinkling of fairies, a murder of crows, or a clattering of jackdaws.